Hey guys, this is Pat Cox. Welcome back to round two of a Fate Reforged draft here on Channel Farble. Yeah, this opener is it's not great. We do have one morph, so if we hit our third land, we get to do that, but can't actually cast any. I mean, we got a five drop. We got not technically a six drop, but pretty close. Certainly not casting anytime soon. I think this is a mulligan. All right, yeah, this is better. Got two drops. Gotta hunt the weak that can give something first strike. That's pretty nice. Guess probably would have bonk in here. Well, seeing as that's gonna sit in my way, sounds better to outlast. Can't actually use this yet, but oh, never mind. Now we can. I actually didn't realize this guy had like he had a tap for the ability at first. Like I picked him much higher than he should have been picked. One of my early drafts that I posted, people got mad at me about it. Well, attacking seems like a losing proposition. So I guess we'll just hang back and first strike his guy if he attacks. Yeah, attacking wouldn't be the worst. I guess I could just trade with this. That's pretty good. Suppose I attack. If he cracks back, I can kill it. He blocks and tries some shenanigans, I can kill that. He's probably just gonna block and sack. Ugh, that is the worst possible thing that could happen. It's probably gonna make me lose the game. Okay. Yeah, being stuck on lands and then having your guy put on top is pretty brutal. Might actually be correct to trade even though I have this thing. Well, that option was removed from me. But I was gonna say, just so I can kill a bigger guy later. I kind of know I'm not doing anything anytime soon. But I don't really want to take three, so I'll just kill Probably doesn't matter, I could take three, but knowing that my next card is not helpful in my situation made me wary. Also, like, I'm going to be using my mana the rest of the game if I'm not dead. Seven drops definitely not getting played this game, I don't think. I mean, maybe if he keeps doing things like cast Smoke Tiller when he has six mana, but all right, that's a good start. Can't really fight anything, but I can play Assault Road Patrol. Let's just hope he's not like trying to get to 10 mana right now or something like. Just has no action, not that he needed this extra mana. Like if I villain if I get Villainous Wealth or Ugin or something, it's not good. This nonsense card. Okay. I guess there could come a point where I like double fight, but not anytime soon. Yeah. Guess I outlast this guy. Luckily, he can't really attack with that, but unless he just taps out somehow for some reason, it is going to be pretty impossible to kill. I guess I can't double fight because both sorceries. Because if I try and fight this, he's just gonna bounce. Give his guy indestructible. I need like a murderous cut. Oh, summon prowler is another thing I can't fight, so that's good. I think starting to attack is probably better than life gain. He still can't really attack me, so. Sorry. If you missed it, my train of thought here is probably not incredibly clear. But I could cast this face down, hoping to draw a white card, and then I get to flip it later. But I'm at 20 life, so I think it's probably better to just be able to start pecking away with him at him with it immediately. Stupid Teemer Sabertooth. This card's so good. What just happened? Okay. Well, I think we're gonna have a hard time winning at this point. I could try and fight something just so he has to bounce it so I don't get attacked with it again. Or I could play this giant thing, that's probably good too. I think this needs to stay back on defense to just block this two drops. So I can't block the Sabertooth, but I can block the Summit Prowler. I mean, I can block whatever I want, but reasonably. Just need it. I want to say I need him to tap 7 mana, but that can't be good for me either, so. I don't really know what I'm supposed to do about the Sabertooth guy. I wonder how good this card is. I've not really even considered picking it, but it's doing work this game. It's just gonna give your guys pseudo vigilance, I guess. Then you gotta recast it. I'm just gonna kill your stupid Sabertooth. Yeah, like why leave the mana for that up all game and then now just not anymore? That's crazy. But I'll take it. As I'm sitting there calling him dumb, he just has another land. Okay. So just so we're clear, none of my fight cards do anything. I got a plus one counter on a guy, that could be pretty good. Could attack. Doesn't sound that great. I mean, it'll be great to start doing that for if I can bolster later, but that's kind of it. Yeah, just now has pseudo vigilance. That's good. I suppose I'll attack. Could be a horrible mistake. This, God, like, if this was, just, I guess there's a lot of cards that could beat me, but against my exact hand, this might be the best card. Just totally turning off all my fight stuff. Like, I feel like if he doesn't have this, I'm in pretty great shape this game. I have, like, all these giant creatures that can just kill these guys. But, I mean, who knows? He might have had it on turn 4 and just, like, left it, waited till turn 6, so he definitely could do that, in which case, kudos. All right. So we'll attack that. Guess I should be thankful he doesn't have like some coming into play effect that he can be reusing, bouncing my guys or something. I don't like this. I don't know what it is, but I don't like it. Spells can't be good. Man. What? You can't. Okay. Well, now I think I might have to use my fight card just because I want to put a counter on my guy so I can block this stupid 5/4. I mean, I could chump like one turn with this, I guess. That doesn't sound very good. I guess I can like try and fight Smoke Teller, and if he lets me, or like if he bounces, then I can fight Summon Prowler and kill it. Yeah, that's probably correct. So, like, I think I try and fight this. If he lets it happen, cool, then I have a 3/5 or a 3/6 that can block this. If he bounces, then I can kill Summon Prowler. Like, put. Yeah, it doesn't fizzle it. Could also play Grim Hearse or whatever, but this sounds better. I mean, I'm guessing he's just gonna bounce this. Who the hell knows? But sure. All right. I'll savage punch this idiot. I'll attack my stupid flyer. Well, my cards finally did something. Yeah, you know, spent 6 mana to essentially just hunt the weak, but that's okay. He has no good attacks, so that's pretty good. Ooh. Should have waited. Damn. So I guess I will cast this face down, attack my Watcher of the Roost. So now I can actually theoretically kill his charger, though he's going to have to tap pretty low for that to happen. But I'm actually in pretty decent shape at this point in this game. Like, it's certainly losable, but he has no good attacks until he removes some of these guys. Sure. Forgot he had that. I don't really know why I bothered even playing that as a morph. I don't really need the mana, so it doesn't matter, but I'll now unmorph it, end of turn, I suppose. Just so, in case I top deck the land for the sand-stepped guy. Ah, man. This guy is going to deal so much damage with this Watcher. Incremental growth. I guess that's fine. Still feel like all his attacks are pretty bad. So he has mana to bounce. I don't know, he can only bounce. No, it's his Thorn One Falls, right? He can bounce two things. So I guess I just chump, right? Not trample or anything. Okay. Go to blocks. Sure. On morph. Can't really murderous cut anything, I'll just bounce it. Well, it's kind of a land, but kind of not. It does give my eyes flying, which is nice, but it's not really that close to dead, so. I guess he might be dead. So that guy's gonna be a 7, 10, 13. So I can deal 13 next turn, which is not 15, so. Not quite dead. Basically, the question is, do I chump with this? And then I get to draw a card, or do I chump with this, and then my guys get flying later? The flying is probably better, but hell if I know. Sure. Yeah, not too sure about that block. Like, it increases my clock by a turn to have the flying as an option. Like, I very well might just be, like, chump blocking with this thing. Which actually isn't that crazy. Could also just have another crazy blocker, but I don't think I want to do that. I'll just attack for my 7. Alright, so, as long as I get to keep one of my two guys sitting here, I should be okay. Let's see. Walk like here. What's this? 6-5. Like, this is a pretty all-in attack. I mean, as long as some guy lives, I'm in pretty good shape. So, it might be better just blocking this way means I'm not as totally screwed if he has a removal spell. Block like, a burn spell. Like, if he has a volley here, that's bad for me. So, let's try to figure out how to block to avoid dying to that. So, even though I was thinking I should jump with this, that probably doesn't really make sense. Can probably just block this here, sure, I guess that's good. Though I guess probably don't need to play around that. It's probably more just he can give these guys pseudo vigilance here. That doesn't really do anything though, because then I can still attack with my guys. Also, I guess he can't ever bounce this, right? Yeah, I mean, that's already like. I guess maybe I shouldn't have blocked with Falconer on this guy. Could have, like, chumped differently and, like, let the three power guy through. Like, chumped with Bonkin or something. Maybe that would have been better. Finally can't use this stupid thing. I guess if he has a bounce spell, he's not dead, but that's really like the only thing. There's a lot of reason to go for it. Probably not. Let's attack with everything, let him chump. Probably not doing anything at any point this game. It's like I could have gone for it there with relatively low risk, but there didn't really seem to be a lot of reason to do that. Like, could just get blown out by a bounce spell, and I'm still probably losing or winning, but I don't know. Didn't seem worthwhile. All right, so what do I have to kill Teemer Sabretooth? Probably nothing. This gets in its way, which is not nothing. Like, maybe it's better than formless nurturing. Yeah, I mean, since it's unkillable, if you have things that can block it forever, that is pretty good. Suppose we'll give this a try.